波を航海士に迎えたルフィは本格的にグランドラインを目指すべくオレンジの街を後にした。航海の途上、新たな船と仲間を求めてルフィたちはシロップ村に上陸。そこで村の少年ウソップと出会う。ウソップは村一番の大ぼら吹きで村人をいつも騒がせていたが、両親を亡くした病弱な少女カヤをほらばらしで元気づける心優しい少年でもあった。意気投合したルフィとウソップが村外れの海岸で話していると、偶然カヤの執事クラハドールが海賊らしき男と不穏な相談をしているのを目撃する。執事クラハドールの正体は元海賊であり、カヤの両親が彼女に残した財産を奪おうと企んでいたのである。
それで計画の準備はできているんだろうな。
えらいこと聞いちまった。あの執事はキャプテンクロー、カヤの財産をずっと狙ってやがったんだ。
夜明けとともに村を襲え、村の民家も適度に襲い、あくまで事故を装い、カヤお嬢様を殺すんだ。聞いた通りだウソップ君、君が何を聞こうとも私の計画に影響はない。
くそ。みんな大変だ、海賊が攻めてくるぞ。
またか、あのホラ吹き坊主。
今日という今日は許さんぞ。
信じてくれよ、本当にみんな殺されちまうんだ。
とっ捕まえろ。
くそ。俺は嘘つきだからよ、鼻から信じてもらえるわけなかったんだ。
でも事実は事実、海賊は本当に来ちゃうんでしょ。
間違いなくやってくる。でもみんなは嘘だと思ってる。明日もいつも通り平和な一日が来ると思ってる。だから俺はこの海岸で海賊どもをお迎え撃ち、この一件を嘘にする。それが嘘つきとして俺の通すべき筋ってもんだ。こんなわけもわからねえうちにみんなを殺されてたまるかよ。
とんだお人よしだぜ。
よし、俺たちも加勢する。
言っとくけど宝は全部あたしのものよ。
ね、お前ら。
Hey guys, Andrew here. We're playing more One Piece Pirate Warriors 3. So as you can see, we're actually doing Usopp's story now. We're hanging up in Sirit Village. We gotta fight Kuro, because Kuro is trying to take over Kyra's whatever place or palace or something like that. I can't remember what the name of the girl is. But yeah, so basically this is gonna be a mission to, if you remember correctly from the show, it was to, they were gonna take position on the hill and prevent the pirates from going up it. But realistically, what ended up happening was they were actually on the opposite hill. There were two hills in Sirit Village, apparently. And there is the one where Luffy and them all came in on, and then there's the other one, which had nothing on it. And they thought the one that had nothing on it was going to have Kuro. It's going to have, spoiler alert, it was going to have Kuro's men. But it turns out it was actually the other one where Luffy's ship was and all that stuff. So they end up having to make a dash to the other side to try to do Usopp's plan, which is, of course, to put tar on the bottom so that way no one could progress up and slip down and blah, 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 and so on. So anyways, the nice thing about this chapter, I will say, is actually the level design is pretty accurate to the story itself. The idea is that the village is in the very far back, and that there are two main slopes that the enemies can come up from to get to the village. And basically you have to protect both slopes from getting enemies to it. I think it's kind of probably the most accurate actually in the entire game as far as how the layout of one of the places or towns works. So I do give them props for that. As you can see, one of our allies for this time is actually Usopp, and Usopp's moves are pretty interesting. It's actually, he's the only one that actually has a two-parter move, which is if you do your all-square attack, he shoots down oil on the ground, and if you press all triangles, then he actually shoots fire. But if you've done the square first, and then you do the triangle, when he does his fire attack, it actually makes the oil that he threw on the ground explode up and create an explosion. So I think that's actually kind of cool that they decided to incorporate a bonus character's attack that actually has a two-part stage to it. It's certainly a mechanic I wish there was a little bit more of. Like, I kind of wish there was a little bit more setup for some people's stuff. Like Nami is a really good example who doesn't get one, but I wish Nami had one where she does like the climate tempo. When you attack her, when you attack with your square, she'll end up just creating a bunch of clouds. And then, but if you attack with your triangle, she'll end up throwing like a thunderbolt ball, and it shoots down a bunch of lightning real quick. But instead, they decided to go for the easier option, which is you do the square, she shows up and just hits a couple of people, and you do triangle, and lightning does come down. But it's not like a buildup. I don't know. I think it'd be kind of cool if like square, she basically did the cloud thing, and while doing it, like the little gray clouds can hit people as they go up into the sky, and then it just, and then like a little cloud follows you around. Until after you do a triangle move with her, and then then lightning comes out of it. So basically the idea is, at the moment what we're doing is we're trying to basically prevent anybody from going up the hill. I've been kind of going around trying to run and clear out all the bases that have people in it, while meanwhile Usopp actually is trying to lie and deceive them into thinking that there is a side path that they can go up on to quickly get to the village, which is true, but Usopp has actually barricaded it. And so he's leading all of them to a trap where the barricade is, so that way they're all stuck in one position so I can go over like I'm about to do now and beat the living crap out of all of them. For those of you who haven't actually paid attention to what's going on with the specials, at least, using specials isn't actually really worth it. You can take out a lot more people actually just doing your regular attack, but what's important about a special is that your special can actually really help at increasing the bar on the side.
もうとうに予定の時間は過ぎてるってのに。キャプテン
Kuro。
なかなか計画が進まねえと思ったら。
Yep, so as you can see, Kuro is waiting to come onto the battlefield until all the pirates have basically been cleared out. He just wants to come in and take all the stuff, and then basically let the pirates do all the dirty work for him. As you can see, that's why he's bringing bombers in now, is to blow up all the barricades that exist. And so pretty much every single base that wasn't taken over is now actually occupied by people. So, like I was saying, when you do the special, as you can see, it actually builds up the meter for your character. When the meter gets all the way to pink, their hero ability activates. And what's important about that is that you press R2 immediately when they have their hero power. And you can actually do a little bit more damage with them, and there's like different special combos that they do when you actually activate them while in hero mode. I don't really tend to bother myself with it sometimes, because it's not really, I would say it doesn't change enough that it warrants me having to waste doing my R2 if there isn't enough people around to do the R2 for. And honestly, the hero power is kind of cool, but it's all about at the very end when you do a special anyways, and the special isn't really impacted much by doing the hero ability. I've never seen what happens when you do, when you get two people to a hero ability, which is possible. If you get two people into their hero abilities really quickly and then activate them, I'm curious if they might actually do something. I haven't done it yet, and it's very, very difficult to, as you can imagine, but so I don't know. Anyways, at the moment, we're trying to, basically I need to go and take out all the big mobs running up to where the barricades are, and give Usopp enough time to actually set up barricades right in front of the village,
or all the slots for the village, so that way literally no pirates can come up there. This is part of a three-part plan, which was like the first one was a barricade we just took care of. The next one is this one he's doing right now. And then the third plan after that is to is going to be to try to oil up the ramp, so that way they literally cannot get up and they're forced to retreat. So we're just kind of buying him time right now. Now that you can see he's done with doing all the barricades, it's more just about trying to take care of the remaining pirates and taking back over the bases that they took over, so that way Usopp has a clear path to go to when he needs to go down to the bottom. So yeah, that's basically about it. But so a little bit about One Piece stuff, because you know that's my favorite segment, is talking about One Piece itself. And one of the things I want to mention is that an interesting thing with Kuro, for those of you who don't actually read the SBSs, which is basically people ask Oda questions and Oda will answer questions. And one of the questions asked was forgot the question. On Kuro, you'll notice that he has he's wearing a suit and has a little embroider on it. And the embroider looks like poop. And someone asked if that was intentional, if that is actually poop embroidered on there. And, of course, being the funny Oda man that he is, he did say, yes, it is poop. So, that is a fun little fact, is that Kuro does have an embroider of poop on his suit. What a classy, classy pirate. But another thing is that actually his... his crewmates, it's weird because his crewmates are like the, I think it's the cats or something like that. They just call them like Kuro pirates or something, but I think there is like a special name for their pirates. And in particular, you notice that he has two side captains, and the two side captains are both cat, basically cosplaying characters somewhat, because I think like one of them literally is like a cat. I don't know, it's kind of weird. But it's like this weird cat theme, and even their ship has like a little giant cat mast on it. And I don't know, there's a lot of weird little cat-related things to Kuro, and even his moves, I think is one of his moves is like cat out of the bag or something. I don't know, it's really weird. I never really looked into it, but I assume there's like some kind of hidden meaning. I'm not sure if like Kuro has any kind of meaning to it or anything like that.
やったな、ウソップ。こそこそ逃げ回って何を生きがっている。そういえば、お前の親父も村を逃げ出した臆病者だったか。臆病者だと？てめえ、それ以上親父をバカにするな。俺は親父が海賊であることを誇りに思ってる。 勇敢な海の戦士であることを誇りに思ってる。俺はホラ吹きだから、俺が海賊の血を引いているその誇りだけは偽るわけにはいかねえんだ。生意気な、今にその言葉を後悔させながら殺してやる。畜生、あの野郎バカにしやがって。ヤゾップだろ、
お前の父ちゃん。お前、なんでそれを知ってんだ。子供の頃に会ったことがあるんだ。お前と顔そっくりだからさ。今もきっと赤髪のシャンクスの船に乗ってるよ。そりゃお前大海賊じゃねえか。そんなすげえ船に乗ってんのか。うちの親父は。俺だっていつか親父みてえだ。勇敢な海の戦士になってやるんだ。
It's really kind of funny that they do make the quick mention about that very early on in the show, that Usopp's dad is Yasop, who is one of the pirates on Shanks' crew. He is actually very noticeable to see in the beginning couple of episodes when Luffy's at the bar and all that stuff. You'll notice him. He does have a headband on that says Yasop, in case you couldn't notice who he was, because he looks pretty much like Usopp minus the nose. But it's funny that Usopp does say that, and it's kind of this weird disconnect that I guess not that some of the seas, like the north, south, east, and west blue, may not be up to date on stuff like who Yonkos are and things like that nature, or maybe just information hasn't spread successfully like that. But it's really weird that that Usopp has no idea that his dad is like on a Yonko ship, and it's not like Shanks recently became one. Shanks has like been a Yonko for a while.
いつもこいつも俺の計画の邪魔をしやがって。時間だ。全員消してやる。
かっこ悪い海賊団だな。お前がキャプテンで、たとえ何百人部下を従えようと、ウソップには勝てねえ。
面白いことを言いやがる。何が勝てねえのか言ってみろ。
お前は本物の海賊を知らねえんだ。
侮辱されたもんだ。ならば教えてやる。幾度となく視線を超えた海賊の恐ろしさを。
あの構え、シャクシだ。シャクシを使う気だ。
シャクシ。
キャプテンクロー、やめてください。無駄だ。これは抜き足での無差別攻撃。いや、それ、本人も何切ってるか分かっちゃいねえんだ。
出てこい羊。お前は仲間を何だと思ってるんだ。
Yep, so now Kuro is doing his out of the bag attack, which is basically like just taking off cat and calling it out of the bag, which is clearly what the reference is. He's also doing the pussyfoot maneuver, which is kind of a weird thing to call your maneuver, I'm just saying. Cats don't really move that fast, but you know, whatever. Anyways, the move that he is actually doing is something that does take place in the show, and it is not as weird as it is taking place here, which is at the current time, basically there will be random spots that highlight in red, like the one behind me, and if you don't get out of the space in time, then what will happen is Kuro will just start slashing in that area, and then those slashes can damage you. It's really easy to avoid, and it's particularly slow, I will say, but in the show, obviously, it was when it took place, it was on the hill, and so on the hill, there really wasn't much place to move. So Luffy was basically standing still, and he's just going back and forth, like, basically up and down this hill. And his crew's in the back and in the front, and they're all getting slashed up. So that's where the idea comes from, that he's like, oh, you're so fast, you can't see who he's slashing! But, I don't know, it's kind of a weird, silly move that doesn't seem to have any benefit to himself, really, because he's just only cutting down his numbers. And not necessarily hitting the enemy at times, since he's moving so fast he doesn't know where if he's hitting enemy or foe, and the enemy could just run away in this time. Like, I mean, if especially in a world where sensory haki exists, you could just leave. I mean, I don't know. It was a conversation that I had, me and a buddy had, which was about, you know, after the once a 2-year time spoiler alert. Anyways, for those of you, because I'm going to be talking about spoilers, because we're at that part of the show now. So, spoiler alert. Me and a buddy were talking about after the 2-year time skip, what stuff that. We were talking about, like, you know, certain enemies that existed in the early arcs, and what do they look like after the 2-year time skip? And one in particular that came up was Kuro. And it's like, what did Kuro change after the 2-year time skip? Because realistically, this entire plan that he's going through right now is actually supposed to be a method for him to retire from pirating for the rest of his life, because he doesn't like to have to keep risking his life and coming up with plans and all that crap, and he'd rather just get a lot of money and vacation. And so we were wondering, like, after a 2-year time skip Kuro, what would that be like? What would that entail? And so some of the things that we came up with was, one of them would be he'd be able to put a haki onto his blades when he's attacking now, which would be kind of cool, actually. I mean, it would be kind of cool to see him put haki on the blades. Another thing, too, would be he actually can hone his ability by his out-of-the-bag maneuver by adding sensory haki to it and being able to know exactly where someone is. And so if you add that, like, super speed and then have precision attached to it, you really put yourself in this situation where it's like, whoa, like, this guy is actually dangerous now. Like, he knows what he's, like, he knows where he's going, and he can really mess somebody up. But, yeah, I don't know. It's kind of fun to think about, like, where some of the people went, you know, after the 2-year time skip. Because since it doesn't really, Oda never really does that much to go back too far. He'll every so often go through and talk about some people that you know and love, but he doesn't really go out of his way to talk about people that you haven't heard about in a long time. And Kuro's one of those kind of people where it's like, why do you even care about Kuro? I mean, the dude lasted for just like an arc, like almost 300, or like, I'm sorry, almost like 500 chapters ago. Like, what the hell do you want from me? And I mean, yeah, realistically, there's no need for an update on Kuro, but it's just kind of fun to think about. I don't know, this is fun to think about. But yeah, so as you can see, there's a timer going down, mission successful. Usopp has now successfully put oil on the ground and people cannot get through. So, huzzah to that!
お前はもう終わりだ覚悟しろ面白いこと言いやがるおめえみてえな臆病者に何ができる今だ小賢しい真似をだ、やったぞでも、ちくしょうもう、体が動かねえよ笑わせてくれるまあ、そこで倒れた方が安全だろうよ。立ち上がったところで、所詮俺たちには叶わねえんだ。叶わなくったって守るんだ。かよも、村のみんなも俺が守る。お前らを通すわけにはいかねえ。俺はいつも通り嘘をついただけなんだから。
Alright, it's boss fight time. Now, I will say there's probably some of you who watch that video and we're kind of like, what just happened? It's kind of a normal reaction. They don't really do a very good job of explaining exactly what the hell is going on, and it doesn't really help that for those of you who have been paying attention, you'll notice that Django actually doesn't make any sort of appearance in this spot, in this episode. So yeah, so it's because Django's not there, there's a little bit of setup that's kind of missed, but they also still try to follow through with the actual events that go on in the series itself. So what ended up transpiring was that he's a little bit worn out because he was basically the setup that he was doing took a lot of effort to put in, basically setting up all the oil and then making it explode, and hopefully was trying to defeat Kuro by doing it. That was the explosion, was him lighting off the oil, and clearly it didn't stop him from moving. It did, in the show it actually does affect him, but it doesn't actually stop him from being strong enough. At this point it's when Luffy takes over and ends up fighting Kuro and taking him down. But which is what's happening here. But it's so poorly, described to you through that video by everything. Just like all the effects are going on so quickly, and you just see Kuro like, huh, and you're like, whoa, 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 whoa! How did you get hit by anything? Are you okay, man? Like, do you need some help or something? But yeah, I don't know. It's really weird. So let's go ahead and just finish off beating Kuro, and we'll end this episode really soon. So we're going to do Kizuna Rush, obviously do Usopp special after beating the crap out of him a few times. And Gum Gum No special oversized cannon. And he's done. Thanks for watching.
お前の3年の計画も完全に失敗だ。なんだと。さすがもの。俺の計画は絶対にこれはない。名前を捨てて海から逃げるような海賊に俺が負けるか。
俺は本気でいる海海賊王になる男だ。海賊クロを倒したルフィたちは村を救ったお礼としてカヤから船を送られた。キャラベル。うおー、ゴーイングメリー号か。 いい船だな。
悪いな。
おう。
お前ら見てたらよ、やっと剣心がついた。俺はこの村を出て本物の海賊になるんだ。元気でな、またどっかで会おう。
なんで？
あ、なんでって、愛想のねえ野郎だな。これから同じ海賊やるんだから、そのうち海で会ったり。
何言ってんだよ、早く乗れよ。
え、俺たちもう仲間だろ。
キャプテンは俺だろうな。
バカ言え、俺がキャプテンだ。